My prediction, based on the keys to the White House system, which has been right for 40 years, is that we are going to have a precedent-breaking president, that Kamala Harris will become the first woman president of the United States. The way it works is the keys are always measured against the White House party. They tap into the structure of elections as votes up or down on the strength and performance of the White House party. And critically, we know Biden withdrew in favor of Harris. That cost the Democrats one key, the incumbency key. But the Democrats finally got smart and united behind Harris, which saved for them the internal party contest key. Plus, Harris has had a positive effect upon a couple of other keys. I think she helped account for the fizzling of the RFK Jr. campaign, since voters didn't have to choose between two old white guys anymore. Hate to say that, being an old white guy. So that had a positive effect on the third party key. And with Biden no longer front and center, I think that dampened the incentive for social unrest. Can things change? Of course. I can't predict what's going to happen in the world, and we have two fluid wars. But I've taken that into account in my call. Even if Harris lost both of my foreign military keys, failure and success, she still would be down only five keys, one short of the six keys that it takes to predict an incumbent party defeat. I think we ought to highlight the fact that the keys are an alternative to the pundits, who have no scientific basis for their opinions, and the pollsters, who give us only snapshots in the polls that are abused as predictors. What makes the keys so different is not only their track record of 40 years of successful prediction, but the fact that they inform us about how elections really work, and it's very positive. It's governing, not campaigning, that counts. The keys measure the strength and performance of the White House party, and they sail above all the individual events of the campaign that the media and the pundits so fasten upon.